Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill John. Well, year end is approaching. This is the time that we always want to see how big our company grew, our mutual funds grew, or anything like that. So let's talk about growth rates. Now, there's a simple calculation to figure out growth rate of 1 year over the previous year. So here we have something that was 100 and went to 120. That formula is the later year divided by the earlier year. Now that's going to give us 120%. So you always need to subtract 1, basically the 100%. So we subtract 1 and we see that that is 20% growth. Well, this concept works great, but let's say we have a couple of years. So the later year divided by the earlier year minus 1. We have 13% growth there. And then copy it down, 27% growth the second year. But usually we're talking about not the average growth rate, but something called a compounded growth rate. And this is a little bit more difficult to calculate. Basically, what we want to do is we want to start out the same way. We want to take the latest year, so in this case, year 3, divided by the earliest year, year 1. And what we have to do is raise that to a fractional power. Raise that to a fractional power. So an exponent is the caret, shift 6. And we're always going to put 1 divided by the number of years from the first year to the last year. So in this case, year 1 to year 3 is 2 years. We raise it to the second power. And then finally, again, this is going to give us a number with 100%. So subtract 1. And we see that that was 20% growth. Now let's extend this. Let's say that we had 145,000 in year 1, 615,000 in year 5. What's the compound growth rate over the 4 years? So we start out last year divided by first year, and we raise that in this case to the 1/4 power because there's 4 years from year 1 to year 5. So 1 divided by 4, and again subtract 1, and it says 43.5%. Now, how do we test this? Let's test and make sure that it's actually working. So we take the year 1, and we're just going to create a test calculation out here. Year 1 times 1.435, and we get 208,000 in the theoretical year 2. We'll do that again to get the theoretical year 3. And then the theoretical year 4 and the theoretical year 5, 614,964.8. Very close to the original number, probably a rounding issue there in my first formula. So when you're calculating compounded growth rates, the math is a little bit tough. You always have to raise it to a fractional power, and the denominator of that fraction has to be the number of years from the first year until the last year. Note that it really does not matter for this compounded growth rate what happens in the intervening years. It doesn't matter whether you grew fast early on or grew in the last year. This calculation is only looking at the earliest year and the latest year to figure out the math. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.